Amazon Web Services, or AWS, provides a web services interface that can be used to store and retrieve data at any time from anywhere on the web. This interface is simple enough that you can retrieve data using a URL, so it's well suited for basic web hosting tasks like serving up media files. The pricing for Amazon S3 is on a pay-as-you-go basis, so there's no minimum fee. This means you don't have to invest in hosting infrastructure or services in order to ensure that your website can handle an occasional traffic spike. It can handle large spikes in traffic without incurring overage fees for exceeding bandwidth. In this course, we'll set up an Amazon S3 account and a CloudFront account to use to serve content and media files. The Amazon S3 account can be used by itself for delivering the media files, but S3 with CloudFront offers the additional speed and performance by delivering files over servers that are close to the customer's location, which delivers the best performance and speed for our media files. We'll set up the Amazon S3 account, and then S2 member will automatically configure CloudFront with Amazon S3 for streaming videos, which makes the process much easier. If you've ever purchased anything on Amazon, then signing up for an Amazon S3 account is a simple process and only takes a few minutes. But it can take up to 24 hours for this account to be active for use. Sign up for an Amazon S3 account at aws.amazon.com/S3. Click the Sign Up button at the top of the page. If you already have an Amazon account, then you'll be prompted to log in to complete the setup. When complete, you'll receive an email confirming the new services account. If you don't have an Amazon account, then you'll be prompted to create one before the S3 account is set up. After the account is set up, navigate to aws.amazon.com/S3 and click the AWS Management Console link and log in. Then, click the Amazon CloudFront link to sign up for a CloudFront account. Click the Sign Up Now button and simply follow the instructions. You don't need to configure the CloudFront services. S2 member will do that for you. Now that the accounts are active, we can configure the S3 account to get it ready for the CloudFront configuration.